So, Post-Scriptum and Hell Let Loose are two video games I've pretty much waited my entire life for. A seemingly super realistic simulation of war. Two games with a lot of similarities and a lot of differences. Now, both of these games are in uncharted waters, seemingly paving their own paths and doing things gaming has really never done before. Now, you would think, if anything, they would support each other and learn from each other, but generally, that's not the case when the internet does what it does best and pits them against each other, almost as if only one of them has the right to exist. Now, if you ask me, that is just ridiculous. This is a brand new genre, and it's only up from here. More players will come and come as time goes on, and there's more than enough room for both to exist. Now, if it was up to me, we would all just get along. And believe it or not, it's more fact than opinion when I say both of these games could learn so much from each other and be beneficial for both rather than tearing each other down. And when I say that, that goes for the devs, the game itself, and the communities. Cover me.
Your body jumped up 6 feet in the air backwards.
All right, dudes and dudettes, let's get a couple of things out of the way. First off, this video, I mean, there's so much to talk about. You can expect another video in the future on the same topic. I'm just going to go over, you know, the main things that I see, like the blatant things. Also, if you're new around here, we've had a giveaway running for a while. We still have a Hell Let Loose key and a Due Process key to give away. If you're interested on entering the giveaway, just stay tuned to like the end of the video and I'll give details on exactly how to enter. Okay, so getting into this, I think it should be known that there may be a slight bias being that I've played Post-Scriptum probably 700 hours and Hell Let Loose only around 100. Now, granted, I come from Squad. I've been playing Squad since Alpha, so when Post-Scriptum released, me being a big World War II guy, you know I was there since day one, and I stuck through it even through the so-called Rocky launch. A lot of people don't know this, but yeah, Post-Scriptum had a really rough beginning, but I've stuck through it and been there since day one. And also, just so that we're all on the same page here, let it be known and understand that Post-Scriptum has been around almost a half a decade longer than Hell Let Loose. So you gotta understand that Post-Scriptum has had quite the head start, considering it's built on the Squad framework. Now, with that said, let's get into what exactly Post-Scriptum could take and learn from Hell Let Loose, and what exactly Hell Let Loose could take and learn from Post-Scriptum. Oh, what do you know? This is a good place to start. The killed in action screen. Why? Okay, I noticed within a recent update that, I think it was the last update, that whenever you were downed in Hell Let Loose, you can now look at the map. It used to not be like that, which is a great move in the right direction. Now just make it so that whenever we're killed, we don't need that 10-second screen. We could at least be looking at the map. There's no need to just be in the dark for 10 seconds. I understand the idea from the developers, and we're going to get into that because that whole idea they have is rubbish. I understand it's about immersion, but we'll go into details on why it's not even needed, really. It's almost as if the Hell Let Loose devs are creating their own like little lore set within World War II itself. Now, granted, it's kind of cool and it can add some depth, but also adds confusion. And with a game like a milsim, it's confusing enough to be adding stuff that's confusing. I mean, let's be serious. I should be a noob in Hell Let Loose, but when I'm running around the game and I'm like, hey, how do you do this? How do you do that? No one knows. Like, everyone is completely clueless as to what is really going on, and that's kind of a problem. I mean, let's be serious. The devs do not make it easy on us whatsoever. Now, this is one of the first times I squad leaded Hell Let Loose. And for me, I'm looking at my squad members, okay? Now, for me to start setting up what I'm gonna do, right off the jump, I'm lost. Because I'm looking at these symbols for each of my squad members. And I don't have a clue what the hell they mean. They're not even trying to be somewhat logical. Here, let me show you the symbols Post-Scriptum uses for each role. I mean, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. Sometimes you gotta follow those that come before you. All right, so granted, in this particular scene, it has the German name of the class right next to the symbol, but that's not what we're looking at here. I'm just talking about the symbols itself. Look at the symbol. You can tell right off the jump. The first one is an STG-44, just so happens to be the squad leader. The second one is a regular rifle. The third one, boom, Pioneer. That's your satchel carrying guy. And then the fourth one, you can see just a little bump on the top of the rifle. That's the scope, which indicates that's the sniper. And then another rifleman, of course the cross for the medic, another rifleman, and you can pretty much tell that that's an MG42. And under the MG42 is a radio. I mean, it looks like it. Why have these crazy symbols that look like something written on the power ring from Lord of the Rings? It's pointless. Now, while we're on the topic, like, Hell Let Loose can be so confusing as to what's really going on with all the resources and stuff like that. I mean, you gotta read a book to really know how to play the game. Now, Post-Scriptum suffers from the opposite problem, where pretty much the whole game is 5 points and two modes. You got advanced and secure and offensive. One, where one team defends, the other attacks, and advanced and secure, where you both gotta defend and attack. Now, granted, advanced and secure is the more challenging mode, but both of them are pretty straightforward and super basic. You either push the enemy all the way back, or you run the enemy out of tickets. Now, it's a great thing that Post-Scriptum finally has modding, so we'll be able to experiment with some different game modes, and I'm super excited to see something more different and in-depth. It's like Hell Let Loose has too much going on, and Post-Scriptum doesn't have enough. If we could both somewhat meet in the middle, I think that would be freaking awesome. Now, of course, it's understood that Post-Scriptum has had a huge head start with adopting the squad framework, but gunplay. Gunplay is the most essential thing about any of these games.
That's a few extra deaths.
Dang, boy.
It's kind of, not gonna lie.
Yeah. Well, they're deep back there. Oh, shit. In the window. Even though Post-Scriptum has had such a huge head start, the one thing, and probably only thing it really has over Hell Let Loose, is the gunplay. Well, besides the community playing the game correctly. As far as the game goes, the gunplay of Post-Scriptum is exceptional. It's definitely a blueprint for how you want your guns to feel, the weightiness, the punchiness. It's all there. And good news, Hell Let Loose is still focusing on gunplay. And if I could say one thing to the Hell Let Loose developers, is always refine your gunplay. Keep working on every update. Work on the gunplay. Work on the guns, how they look, how they feel, the trajectory, the bullet drop, penetration, any and every system you can revolving around gunplay and ballistics. Keep working on it. It's been such a short time, and they've come such a long, far way already. And this past development 8, yeah, it came with some problems, but overall, we got ballistics and penetration, and it's just going to take time, more and more updates to refine these systems. So, if you're a Hell Let Loose player, do know, have some patience, give it time. These updates are going to improve things, and they're going to break things. It's going to take several updates until everything is refined and how it's intended to be. But like I said, I was reading the last dev blog, and they were talking about zeroing and making the guns look better and improving optimization. So it's a good thing. So far, every freaking update, Hell Let Loose has been doing something along the lines with gunplay. So that's awesome. Keep up the great work. I myself, being a Kickstarter backer, I am more than happy with where the game is going. Now, I was scared there a little bit because I thought all the money that was coming in at first was they were going to turn the game into an arcade game, but I've since been calmed and I see where the game is headed, and I can tell that the developers still plan on building a proper mill sim, however complicated and confusing it might be. Well, golly day, we seemingly are running out of time. 10 minutes seems to be about the average YouTuber's attention span, so I don't want to go talk too much further. However, there are a couple more things I want to go over before we end this, and like I said, we're definitely going to do some more videos on this, because I could just talk all day about this exact topic. There is so much, not only the devs, but the communities too, could learn from each other. Now, being that Post-Scriptum is the older game and has been around longer, and is one of the first mil sims proper, the communication tends to be so much better in Post-Scriptum. When I go into Hell Let Loose, I find myself leaving 7 squads until I find a squad willing to talk, communicate, and work together. Now, that is just horrible for the game. And granted, developers, you could do a little more to help that as far as making it easier and more streamlined, just like I was saying about the symbols. Like, when I was trying to squad lead, and I did not know who was who. I didn't know who my engineer was. I didn't know anything. And little things like that could go a long way. See, watch as I give commands here, and people actually listen. And I don't know them from Adam. It's awesome. Ooh, some MG fire coming in. Stay down. Everybody stay put. Look, MG, I got an MG right here. I mean, I guess we'll just have to save that entirely for a whole nother video, because I could just go on and on about the community itself, for that matter. I mean, why we're on forums and stuff going at each other's throats when we should be coming together? Like, let's support the entire genre. That way, when new players come in, they feel welcome, they feel cozy, and you know what? They can pick the game they want to main, you know? I tend to main Post-Scriptum, but I also play Hell Let Loose. You want them to bring them to both games, not tell them, oh, this one sucks and this one's good. But anyway, we're going to save a whole nother video for just the topic of community. I want to say one last thing about Post-Scriptum, that something Post-Scriptum could learn from Hell Let Loose, and that is just simply micro-terrain. Very seldomly are you crossing a field in Hell Let Loose that is just completely empty. And I love that about Hell Let Loose. Every field, every little nook and cranny of the map is handmade, and it seems like it was set up for gunfights. That is something that Post-Scriptum definitely needs to take from Hell Let Loose. And I'm sure in the future they will do optimization passes and hopefully some micro-terrain passes on existing maps. I've heard them talking about adding interiors to old maps. That would be something I'd love to see, some more micro-terrains in these empty fields that we get stuck on with no choice but to pop smoke or something like that. But anyway, I want to thank everybody for watching. I want to thank everybody for subscribing. We're headed to 1,000. If you're not subscribed, please subscribe to the channel. Like I said, we're going to be doing giveaways all the time, so there's some shit in it for you too, bub. Help me get to 1,000. I get monetized at 1,000 subs, whatever that means. I don't know if it's 20 bucks. It's probably chump change, but Lord knows I need it. Good gosh. I'm working my butt off and still barely making enough to get by. This corona thing, it looks like it's not going anywhere anytime soon. So a little YouTube money could go a long way. I would just want to appreciate each and every one of you. And like I said in the past, a lot of that money I'm going to put right back into this channel and the giveaways and stuff like that. So I'm glad to have you all. I want to thank you all for watching one last time. And oh yeah, the giveaway. Let's give away a key right now. Crazy Dog, you won, my brother. Come on down, message me in Discord or however you can get a hold of me. You can select from either Hell Let Loose or the game Due Process. As for everyone else, we got another giveaway. Next weekend, we'll draw another winner. So if you want to enter these next couple videos going up into the weekend, you just got to comment on one of those videos and leave your Discord name. So the whole way to enter, you got to be a little part of our community here. All you got to do is subscribe to the channel, like this video, and comment. But within your comment, leave the Discord name so that if you win, I have no problem getting the right person the right key. And if you wouldn't mind, share this with people. Share this with people who are interested in Milsims. Share this with people who play Call of Duty. Say, hey, come see these games. This is what you want to play. You want to play Call of Duty. Share this with your friends, your family, whoever. I'd greatly appreciate it. All right, guys. Thanks a million. Y'all be good to each other.